you do, folks? How do you do? This is Johnny Mercer inviting you to spend the next 15 minutes with us in a special radio preview of Walt Disney's new musical drama, Song of the South. Here to greet you are such new Disney personalities as Luana Patten, Bobby Driscoll, James Baskett, and of course the man who's given the world some of its greatest movies, Walt Disney. So come on while we chat and sing a bit, latch on to some of this fun.
You'll want to see it again and again. It's Song of the South with Songs for a Nation, the picture all Hollywood is talking about. In this new Walt Disney full-length Technicolor hit, you'll thrill to the gay, heartwarming stories based on the tales of Uncle Remus. You'll sing and whistle its glorious music. You'll love the new Disney youngsters, Bobby and Luana. And you'll get a thousand laughs at Disney's three great new comedy characters. Be sure and see Song of the South when it plays your town.
You know, friends, like I said, this is going to be a little informal get-together session with Walt Disney and the others. We're just sitting around talking about the wonderful time they had making their new picture.
I'll say we had a wonderful time, Mr. Mercer. I don't want to.
We sure did.
When Luana and I weren't working on the set or going to school on the lot,
we got to see all the Donald Duck movies we wanted. And boy, was that fun.
We got to see Mickey Mouse and Pluto, too.
As you can see, Johnny, the younger generation liked the movie business.
My guess is they like working for you, Walt.
You can say that again, Johnny.
Well, Jim Baskett, I thought you were down in the Briar Patch.
Just call me Uncle Remus, sir. Everybody else does.
Say, who do you have following you there, Uncle Remus?
Looks like some of his best friends. That little fellow's Brer Rabbit.
And Brer Fox. And Brer Bear.
They're pretty new around here. You see, they were just born and brought up in Song of the South.
What a gang. Where'd you find them, Uncle Remus?
Well, seems like wherever I go, these boys just take to following me.
Have you ever met them, Johnny?
That little guy with the white tail feathers looks familiar.
I'm Donald Duck. I'm the head man around here.
Why, Donald, how'd you get in here?
I don't remember seeing him in Song of the South.
Don't mind me, Johnny. I'm just trying to hear an Uncle Remus story.
Seems like the little man with the gravel voice is just a mite jealous of the new boys.
But if he don't quit bothering me...
What you say, Brother Bear?
I says if he don't get out of here, I'm just gonna knock his head clean off.
You are too loose. I'm the strongest little guy in the world.
Uh-huh, Donald. Brother Bear is pretty tough.
And so am I. I's Bear Rabbit. I's known as the outdoorsest, most bodacious critter in the South.
Yeah, Bubba, yeah, that?
You ain't so smart, Brother Fox.
Just your ass, Uncle Remus, fine.
Uncle Remus, ain't I the smartest one?
Now, look here. Y'all just keep me out of this.
That's what I said. Now tell me, Uncle Remus, what about a story?
Donald Duck, you've heard enough stories.
Yes, and anyway, we're here to tell the folks about Song of the South.
Song of the South? So that's it. A conspiracy. That's what it is. A conspiracy.
Now, take it easy, Donald. Take it easy.
You people go and make a technical picture, and you don't even put me in it. You're useless, and you don't care.
I resent that, sir.
And so do I, Spock Box.
The Uncle Remus, do you want I should knock his head clean off?
Now, boys. You ain't in the Briar Patch.
I'm not afraid of him, but...
Tell you what, Donald Duck.
Yes, Uncle Remus.
How's for you and me and the boys going over there to that corner and I'll tell you one of my stories.
Sure, Uncle Remus.
Well, then, come on, let's go.
Can I come too, Uncle Remus? And me?
Sure you can. Come on along.
Man, his stories are magic, Walt.
Yes, they are, Johnny. Now, if you excuse me, I think I'll join Uncle Remus for a while. I'd like to hear one of his stories, too.
Well, I declare. I guess the only thing for me to do then is sing one of his songs.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Fine, how are you?
Fine, how are you?
Great day of seeing, great world to be in. Sunshine and brightly, breeze blowing lightly.
Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay. My, oh my, what a wonderful day. Plenty of sunshine heading my way. Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay.
Mr. Bluebird on my shoulder.
It is the truth, it's actual. Everything is satisfaction, zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay. Wonderful feeling, wonderful day.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Fine, how are you?
Fine, how are you? Making a dollar a minute.
Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay. My, oh my, what a wonderful day. Plenty of sunshine head my way. Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay.
Mr. Bluebird on my shoulder.
It's the truth.
It's actual.
Everything is satisfactual. Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay. Wonderful feeling, wonderful day.
My, oh my, what a wonderful day.
Plenty of sunshine head my way.
Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay.
Mr. Bluebird on my shoulder.
It is the truth, it's actual.
Everything is satisfactual. Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay. Wonderful feeling head my way. What a wonderful zippity-doo-dah.
Sure as my name's Johnny Mercer, that song's going to be whistled and sung by most everyone in America, Walt.
And I might add, folks, that's just the way Johnny and the Pied Piper sing it in Johnny's new Uncle Remus album, being released soon by Capitol Records. Capitol Records, that is. And that's a sincere plug, son, for sure.
Well, thank you truly. Truly, that is. Also goes to prove, Walt, that I've never seen a Disney picture yet which didn't come up with a couple of hits.
Well, that's what we try to give the people, Johnny. Plenty of laughs and a lot of good music.
And Song of the South is filled with both. Say, where's Bobby and Luana and the rest of them?
Still listening to Uncle Remus and his story.
I wonder if Uncle Remus would mind if we sort of eavesdrop on him.
Oh, I don't think he would, Johnny. We might catch the end of his story.
Well, come on, let's try it.
There he is, in the corner.
Must be a good one. Look at the gleam in the eyes on those kids.
Well, it certainly must be good. That's the longest time I ever heard Donald Duck keep quiet.
Here we are. Let's listen.
But just in time, Br'er Rabbit got away. And old Fox just looked and looked at Br'er Bear swinging in his trap. Old Fox, he was mad.
You big fool, I catch you in my trap. Just when I had the little rascal all caught and tied.
Duh, I ain't done nothing. I was just making a dollar a minute.
You was not making a dollar a minute, you rabbit thief. You was making a fool out yourself, that's why.
I was too making
you
a dollar.
You wasn't making nothing.
I was too.
Give me the head, Brother Fox. Cribbing about Brother Fox.
I told you he was the most bodacious critter in the whole world. And as some would say, he stayed in his briar patch. And as some would say, he didn't. But there's one thing they all agree on. Tain't no use running away from trouble.
That little critter sure got around, didn't he, Uncle Remus?
Yes, sir, he sure did get around. And if I had time, I'd tell you all about the story of Br'er Rabbit and the Tar Baby.
I'll tell you what, let's settle for a song.
Good. Sing Uncle Remus sad.
Just for you, honey. I'll do that.
All right, Jim Baskett. Just what did Uncle Remus say?
Uncle Remus, Uncle Remus said,
come on and gather around me, all you little children, before y'all go off to bed. Now just give me your attention and hear what old Uncle Remus got to say. I'll tell you just how the animals got that way. Now the leopard's pappy, he got the gout from eating too much speckled trout. His mammy dreamed of polka dots, and that's how the leopard got his spot.
That's what Uncle Remus said. That's what Uncle Remus said.
From speckled trout and polka dots,
that's how the leopard got his spot. More, more, tell us more.
The pinky saw his monkey friend a swinging by his other end. He tried the same thing on a rail, and that's why the pig's got a curly tail.
That's what Uncle Remus said. That's what Uncle Remus said.
He tried the same thing on a rail.
That's why the pig's got a curly tail.
That was wonderful, Jim Baskett. And what Uncle Remus said won't soon be forgotten either.
What did you say the name of the picture was?
It's called Song of the South, Donald.
Song of the South? What was telling you, Donald?
Well, come on with me. I'll take you to it.
Okay, Charlie. I'll go on one condition.
You go on... what's that, Donald?
I'll go to Song of the South with you if you show a Donald what song was it.
Well, goodbye, Donald. Thanks for dropping in on us. Now, friends, since Johnny Mercer is one of the finest composers in the business today, I'm going to ask him to name his favorite song from Song of the South. How about it, Johnny?
Well, Walt, I've seen your picture a couple of times now, and each time I come up with a different favorite. But there's one song in particular which I think is really fine.
And which one is that, Johnny?
It's the one Hattie McDaniel sings, Sooner or Later. And here to sing it is that Capitol Record favorite, June Hutton. Friends, that's about all we have time for now. Thanks to Walt Disney, Bobby Driscoll, Luana Patten, and James Baskett for being with us. And I'm sure we all had fun getting a peek at what's coming in Walt's new picture, Song of the South.
What about me?
And thanks to you, Donald Duck. And we all hope you'll like Song of the South as much as we all like you, too. So for now, this is Johnny Mercer saying...
Everybody has a laughing place to go, ho, ho. Take a frown, turn it upside down, and you'll find yours, I know, ho, ho.
Yes, everybody's got a laughing place. And right now, America's favorite laughing place is the theater showing Walt Disney's brilliant new musical drama, Song of the South, based upon the immortal tales of Uncle Remus. Remember, you'll want to see it again and again. Walt Disney's Song of the South.